I just wanna have some fun.
Hey guys, welcome back to Stanley Parable. Last time we were here, we actually beat the game. So, we're gonna see if we can break it.
All of his co-workers were gone. Oh, please.
Come on.
Are you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door 5 times. Is that all that you
think
an achievement is worth? No, 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 no.
Oh.
I can't just give these merits away for such little...
What?
A measly 5 clicks. Now, suppose you were to click the door 20 times. I would say that's the kind of effort that warrants recognition.
Oh. Spam!
I have to say, I'm still not feeling the satisfaction of witnessing true effort for a noble cause. Perhaps 50 clicks will do it. Yes, almost certainly 50 clicks.
I'm spamming this bitch. I'm gonna fucking get this, whatever this is. I have no idea what this is.
No, no, I'm still not feeling it. I want this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for valiant effort. I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost.
Oh, God.
Why don't you go put 20 clicks into door number 417?
Mother... Where... Duh. All right, 417. Why not? Or 20. Nah, nothing. Alright. Let's go to 417. Ah, here it is. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now, go click a few times on door 437.
437? Where's 437? I need to find these doors, man. Ah, here it is.
Excellent. I think we're getting somewhere. Now, door 415. Let's give it 10 clicks or so.
All right, 415. I'm liking this game. This is a cool game. 415. 415, ha! Two.
Now, back to door number 437.
All right! I have no idea what I'm doing, but fuck it, why not? All right, 437.
Let's see. How about you click on, well, I don't know, the copy machine?
Where's the copy? Oh, that's the copy machine.
All right, back to room 417. I'm really feeling it now. I think we're getting somewhere.
What the fuck am I doing?
Okay, now go climb on employee 419's desk.
Employee 419. How do I do this?
Yes!
Oh!
This is great. You're putting it all on the line, Stanley. I like that. All right, let's keep it up. Go give me a few clicks on door 416.
416? Okay. Let's go. Yeah.
We've almost got it. Now the copy machine, do that one again.
All right. Okay. The hype. The hype. The hype. The hype.
Finish it off, Stanley.
Yeah.
Clicks on door 430.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, wow. That felt amazing. Oh, you really earned it, Stanley. Nothing could hold you back.
Yee!
I'm proud of how far we've come today. Just think, only a few minutes ago, you believed an achievement was worth 5 little clicks. Really, now, what were you thinking?
I was just spamming stuff! Oh, wait! Got a chair! Ooh! Oh! I can get on stuff! I've been fucking get... Cha? Anything down here? Oh. Oh! Uh-oh.
At first, Stanley assumed he'd broken the mask, until he heard this narration and realized it was part of the game's design all along. He then praised the game for its insightful and witty commentary into the nature of...
What the fuck?
And its So, now that you're here, what do you think? Isn't this a fun and unique place to be? Why don't we take a minute just to drink it all in? Okay, I'm over it now. What do you think? Are you sick of this gag yet?
Oh, no.
Ah, then in that case, we'll continue. But now, here comes the real question. What do you think would have happened if you had told me that you wanted this to stop? Do you think it would have been particularly different? would I have taken the same idea but rephrased it superficially to fit that answer? Perhaps you never would even have thought of it if I hadn't brought up the issue in the first place.
That's right.
Now, think about it. Will it be worth it for you to restart and then come back here just to do the other option? Clearly, this whole gag takes some time. What if the other option is even longer? How long will you spend in total just to have heard all the narration?
All the time!
Perhaps you've just played the other option, and now you've come to see what happens in this one. So, what do you think? Which choice was the better one? Imagine if you were to continue on your first playthrough, how tantalizing it would be not knowing what happens when you pick the other option. Indeed, you are one of the lucky ones. Though if the other option is really miserable to listen to, then perhaps you're not. I'm just going to say that no one who's listening to this is lucky. Well now, I've built up the other option so much that I'm going to stop talking and leave you to your decision whether to come back here, continue with the game, or just sit in this spot forever and ever. Cheers.
But first, yes. How do I go back? Can I go back? Can I not press it? What? That's fucking bullshit! Let me press the button! Let me! Come on, this is fucking crap. Alright, begin the game again. Lovely. Alright. Okay. Alright. Alright.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Hello?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Fuck you.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
But I want to... Ooh, buttons! Oh. Huh. That has to do with something. Has to do with the computer. Damn it, I can't go back. Huh. Because I'm looking at the computers. And, like, it's saying input received. See? Input received. So do I have to, like, restart this 5 times? Ooh. Let's try it. I'm actually going to do this. I'm actually going to try this 5 times over. I'm down to do that. I actually want to try this out.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Right. That one's... Come on. Damn it. No. Where is it?
When Stanley came to a set of...
No! No, doors, fuck!
He entered the door on his left.
You know what? Fuck it. Let's go right.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
All right. No, I don't. I'm vagrantly disregarding you now.
Yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room.
Indeed it is.
Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
All right, ooh. What am I hearing?
Yes, really worth it being here in the room.
This is funny. I love this.
Captivating. That even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really worth it.
Because why the fuck not? Why can't I? Huh?
At this point, Stanley's obsession with this room bordered on creepy.
What the fuck?
It's possible.
It's so creepy.
Everyone left.
It's so creepy at all. Can I get a drink?
Stanley sat around waiting for more dialogue. But when a long time had passed and there was no more, he decided that the game was trying to send him a message.
Okay, fine, we'll go.
But at last, he'd had enough of the amazing room, and put the first open door on his left to get back to business.
No. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, that looks new. Alright, but let's go this way. We'll get back to that.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Because... Oh, do I go down here?
Look,
oh.
Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
No, we haven't.
Not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time.
True.
There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself.
I want you, I'm a big boy!
I'm asking for her.
Who?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Yes! Wait, who is this her? What's this?
That's her, Stanley.
Oh.
You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
I must pick up the phone. Hello? Can you hear me?
Oh, Stanley, is that you?
Oh.
Hold on, sweetie. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm just pulling the bread out of the oven. All right. Okay, there we go. All right, now, I want you to come in and tell me all about
your damn boy.
That is fucking creepy.
Oh, come on. Did you actually think you had a loving wife?
Kind of wished.
Life to you. I'm trying to make a point here, Stanley. I'm trying to get you to see something. Come inside. Let me show you what's really going on here.
Sure.
This is a very sad story about the death of a man named Stanley.
What? I?
Stanley is quite a boring fellow.
All right.
He has a job that demands nothing of him, and every button that he pushes is a reminder of the inconsequential nature of his existence.
Okay.
Look at him there, pushing buttons, doing exactly what he's told to do. Now he's pushing a button. Now, he's eating lunch. Now, he's going home. Now, he's coming back to work. One might even feel sorry for him, except that he's chosen this life.
Okay, Q.
But in his mind,
Q, Q, Q.
In his mind, he can go on fantastic adventures.
Yes.
But behind his desk, Stanley dreamed of wild expeditions into the unknown.
I'm so confused. What the fuck's going on?
It was wonderful. And each day that he returned to work was a reminder that none of it would ever happen to him.
Oh, E. Yes.
And so he began
what the fuck?
To fantasize about his own job. First, he imagined that one day while at work, he stepped up from his desk to realize that all of his co-workers, his boss, everyone in the building had suddenly vanished.
What?
Off the
Where's my TV?
The thought excited him terribly.
Where's my TV?
So, he went further. He imagined that he came to two open doors and that he could go through either. At last, choice.
What?
It barely even mattered what lay behind each door. The mere thought that his decisions would mean something was almost too wonderful to behold.
Okay, let's make some dinner.
As he walked through this fantasy world,
what the fuck?
He began to fill it with many possible paths and destinations.
Ew!
In one path lay an enormous round room with monitors and mind controls. And down another was a yellow line that weaved in many directions. And down another was a game with a baby. And he called it the Stanley Parable.
So, we pretty much just got the understanding of how this game was made, why it was made, And... what? Hold on. So the narrator is narrating on the fact that we created a game that he is technically narrating, so he's making the game by telling... He's narrating the game about the game we made that he is narrating us that we made. What the fine fuck?
It was such a wonderful fantasy, and so in his head, he relived it again, and then again.
See?
Again, over and over, wishing beyond hope that it would never end, that he might always feel this free. Surely there's an answer down some new path, mustn't there be? Perhaps if he played just one more time.
But get out! This is not my wife, though.
But there is no answer. How could there possibly be? In reality, all he's doing is pushing the same buttons he always has.
There's no wife! Changed.
The longer he spends here, the more invested he gets. The more he forgets which life is the real one.
Alright,
And I'm trying to tell him this. That in this world, he can never be anything but an observer. That as long as he remains here, he's slowly killing himself. But he won't listen to me. He won't stop. Here, watch this. Stanley, the next time the screen asks you to push a button, do not do it.
Fuck you.
You see? Can he just not hear me? How can I tell him in a way that he'll understand that every second he remains here, he's electing to kill himself? How can I get him to see what I see? How can I make him look at himself?
Can you see what I see? Question nothing!
I can't. Not in the way I want him to. But I don't make the rules. I simply play to my intended purpose, the same as Stanley. We're not so different, I suppose. I'll try once more to convey all this to him. I'm compelled to. I must. Perhaps, well, maybe this time he'll see. Maybe this time.
Maybe.
And I tried again.
What the f-
And Stanley pushed a button. And I tried again. And Stanley pushed a button.
Okay. And I... What? Okay? The fuck? Oh, that... Oh, okay.
Wait, Stanley thought to
himself. All right.
Am I sure that the orders stopped coming in?
Wait, what?
How is that possible?
This is new!
They never stopped. Surely I was mistaken.
Well, that's new. Alright. Can I push anything? Alright. That's so weird. That was so weird. What the fuck?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way
no,
to...
No, I know that. Whatever, blah, blah, blah. Fuck you.
Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Oh, no.
Wow.
I don't care about this place. Blah, blah, blah.
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Oh, yeah, I did.
And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Nope. Fuck you. Now we go. Yeah. Yeah. I have no idea what I just did. I did something.
But Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now in order to get back, he needed to go, from here, it's, left.
Can I go right? Can't go right? What?
Oh, no. No, it's to the right.
Okay. Alright.
No, 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 no.
Which
no.
way?
Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking? It's clearly... Oh, dear, would you hold on for a minute?
What the fuck?
Now, let's see. We went down right, left, down, left, right. Yep, okay, okay, yes. I've got it now.
What sorry. The fuck?
This way.
What? Where the hell did this come from? What the fuck? Alright. Okay. Okay. Alright. Wait, we're back here again.
No, this isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your eyes.
No, fuck you.
Okay. We just have to get back to, who am I kidding? It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable. How about, rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game from the beginning. And this time, suppose we don't wander so far off track, hmm? Okay, from the top.
Alright! What the fuck? Okay.